Hello guys! In this video, I will continue the finances topic. As money is a big mystery for many artists, I want to uncover these pieces with you. Welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist, and on this channel we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today I will show you how the basic calculation for a simple visualization project may look like. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. There are different types of pricing. For instance, time-based pricing, where you can charge based on hours spent on the project. Or you can charge based on the project. There is also another method called value-based pricing, when you charge based on the created value for the client. I think project-based pricing is the most common one, so I will focus on this one today. Okay, well, what is it? It will be a flat fee offer, so this basically means that, for instance, somebody asks you how much a visualization costs, you estimate it and tell them the price. So you think about similar projects you have done before, and based on your experience, you calculate the price. Let me show you the example of the calculating process. Let's say that client come to us and after the conversation, we know that he needs two visualizations of interior and one additional vignette that includes the same space shown in one of the other views, plus one exterior. Not a complicated or complex project that involves lots of working hours. Okay, so let me open the Google Sheets template. Here we go. As you can see, we have the production first. So here, I will put all the information we have. So we know that we'll need two visualizations, so the quantity will be two. Then one vignette image and one exterior. Now, we need to estimate the price for each of them. How can we do this? If you have never worked on a project before and you have no idea how much to charge per image, you can help yourself by using hourly calculations so you have better understanding what price it could be. So now, I go to the pre-calculation section. When working on the project, we have production costs, which change depending on the project, but we also have some fixed expenses, so the ones that don't really change. For instance, renting, monthly billings, and so on. It all influences the price. For instance, let's start from the rent. If you work from home, and let's say this is our case here, we put zero. We don't have space to invite the client and talk with him, so it's different kind of service, different experience for the client. As a result, our service is cheaper. But if we have such expenses, we should put the average cost here. Now, average billings per month. So electricity, gas, internet, phone, all of your billings related to the business in total. You can separate all of this if you want. Of course, if you work from home, you shouldn't put the cost of the whole family, just this what relates to your business expenses. Let's assume it will be $400 in total. Then hardware, for instance. This is a quite tricky one, as we need to estimate it somehow. Let's say that the average cost of the professional computer set will be $5,000, and we can use it for 3-4 years effectively. Then we'll change it, or maybe we will need to repair some things, update, whatever. If we divide this amount per 3 years, let's say, we'll get something around $150 per month. It should be quite relevant. And lastly, the cost of the software in total. You can calculate it similarly as you calculated the hardware. Most softwares are subscription-based, so it will be easy to do. So you have to figure out what is your total average cost per month. I put $300 here. Okay, so we can see that we have the total fixed expenses, $850 per month. We can of course add some other things here if we have anything else, but this is here to show you the idea how it works. Okay, so the average number of working days is 20-21 per month. So we can assume that the one working day will cost us around $40. Now, we can go to the cost of the production. Let's calculate the standard interior image. Because it's not a big project, only one person will be working on that. I would say we can work 3 days in total on the interior shot. Let's say artist hourly rate is $40. These costs are hypothetical. As we're from different countries, we have different rates and expenses, we have different national markets, and so on. But I want to give you an idea how to calculate it. And you can put your own rates and expenses and calculate your costs. So here we have the cost of the production. Let's say that in this price, we have rendering time included to make it all easier. By the way, if you have the situation that the client needs to re-render something, you should also calculate the rendering time in your cost, as this is the time you cannot work on your machine. But anyway, let's go back to our calculations. I would advise to always adding the buffer for mistakes, some unpredicted problems, etc. 10% will be fine. Okay, so this price here is the sum of production cost and the fixed cost according to their consumption during the project. We can round it to $1,200 to make our calculation easier. The process is similar for others, but I won't go through this process again. We can estimate it. So, because the vignette is less work, because we've already made some work for interior projects, so we can assume it will be 75-80% of the price of the interior. So it will be something around $900. And the exterior, it's more work, so let's say it's $1,500. Okay, so we have the total production cost done. By the way, if you would like to learn more not only about pricing, but about managing creative businesses in general, I'd like to invite you to check out our business training that includes 12 modules and 100 videos in total. I put the link in the corner for your reference. Important topics that many artists unfortunately ignore. Anyway, let's go back to our calculations. But this is not everything. We also have management costs. So for instance, let's say project management like emails, contacting clients, managing feedback and so on. I will say it can take around 5 hours. Let's keep it simple and let's put $40 per hour. And let's add 2 hours for creative director. The same rate. It's an easy project, so we don't really need much more. Then we can estimate some additional costs. For instance, 5 extra 3D models. The average price for each will be $20. We could add some additional things if required in the project as well. And finally, the profit margin, which is actually our profit as a company. We can set 15%. And now we have the total price. We'll round it up to $6,000. It's because we want it to look as a project-based quote, not as an hourly pricing, even if we help yourself by using this method. It always needs to look professional. Now, it's really important to remember, the profit margin is what you actually earn if you have a business. I'm sure you can easily see that if you do all this by yourself, you can earn more than we're working alone. And it's true. Basically, you earn as an employee and as an owner. However, it also has some limitations. Let's talk about it a bit. So for instance, if you're on holidays, you don't earn money. So you don't work, you don't earn. Another thing is that you cannot scale your business as you have limited time you can use per day. There is a quick limit to your earnings, which is connected with the limited time. And you have less time for everything that includes your personal life, as you need to work for a few people. It can of course work great for you, but it requires deeper analysis, plus you should be aware of the limitation. Anyway, you have the idea now how you can quote in the future. Okay, I hope this video was helpful for you and make the future calculations easier. Let me know in the comments if you like this kind of videos, if you enjoy the video, and if you feel more confident right now. Finally, I would like to invite you to check out our business training, where you will learn not only about pricing, but also about managing the projects, communication with clients, social media marketing, selling, building a team, and much, much more. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye!